In this lesson, we will learn about for loop in JavaScript. So let's go and define a for loop, and we will also understand what a for loop is. So let me say where I is equal to say 1. So we have defined a variable I and given it the value 1. Now let me say for I is equal to 1, I less than 5, I plus plus. And let me say here document dot write I, and because we want everything to be written into next lines, I will just add a br tag. So let's do this. Now let me run this code. What do we get here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what is happening here? So we have defined a for loop. So what is for loop doing? This part of the loop is known as initialization. This is my condition and this is my increment. The initialization will happen only once. So at the start, I has become 1. Every time in the loop, it will check the condition. What's the condition? I less than 5. Is 1 less than 5? Yes. So it will check the condition and it will go in. And once it goes in, what will write? It will write 1. So what do we get on the screen? We get 1 written here. It will go in at the end of the loop, it gets an increment, so I has become 2, and it will keep on going in. And till when will it go in? Till this condition is violated. When I becomes 5, 5 less than 5 is false, so it will come out. So this is what a for loop is here. So what we have created here is a very basic for loop, and we have been able to run this for loop here. So we could have also said something like this at the end of it. To just say document dot write end of for loop, and let me put a br tag and a semicolon here. Now let's run it. So at the end of the for loop, it's come out of the for loop and it has printed end of the for loop. So this is a for loop here. If I change the value of I from 5 to say 3, what will happen? What will get printed is 1 and 2, because when I becomes 3, the condition will be false and it will come out of it. Let's run the code. So we get 1, 2 and end of for